flag on the play.
Yeah, yeah.
Flag on the play.
Hold up.
That's a flag on the play. Let's go.
Touchdown, I just scored a whole bucket. I just dropped a bag on the tag, ain't nothing. Make them throw a flag when I pass, come through stunning. Call me Ty, girl, and hit the hole, then I ran it. Get money, let's go. You ain't trying to get that sack of flag on the play. Hating from the sideline, a flag on the play. Like Julio with them Falcons, I just made a play. In the red zone, going strong, watch me shake and bake.
Let's go.
I just took off with that rock, just like Tyreek Hill. Get them out of here. I just got a set like I run up in the backfield. I just got a set like I ran up on a quarterback. Shake and bake, make a play just like a quarterback. We ain't worrying about no formers, we ain't staying there. Running off the block, yeah, I'm something like a linebacker. I got juice like a Fanta, how you like it?
How you like it?
I'm on purple, I'm on yellow, like a Viking.
Like a Viking.
All these plays that I'm catching, I done gone crazy. I do my thing, see.
Well, later tonight, a November snowfall is forecasted to hit the Twin Cities, but right now, calm outside, and of course, a calm day inside U.S. Bank Stadium in Minneapolis. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Carolina Panthers and the Minnesota Vikings. They'll come out with a three tight end look on the first play of the drive. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Nice way to start the drive, a gain of 12 and a first down.
Well, there's plenty of real estate for him to maneuver on that run, and let's face it, it shouldn't be a surprise. He's one of the better backs in the league. Had to come into this game with the idea, slow him down, otherwise it's going to be a long afternoon.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Looking to throw it, Minshew. Tight end O.J. Howard, and he gets it to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. A good pickup there, 21 yards.
43-yard line.
So from Panther territory now, it's first and 10 at the 43. Now a handoff here to his running back. Not much there, maybe a couple as he's taken down at the 40.
He's tackled at the 40.
The last run got a couple, here's second and 8.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense rallying to the football and getting him on the ground, but I think the play gets made by the defensive front, because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole.
And that one goes incomplete. He's maybe lucky it wasn't a fumble as he got hit as he threw it. The line to gain is the 33 on third down. Now Minshew. He's got a man wide open, complete. And he will have a Vikings first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Give him 18 there and give the Vikings a first down. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he's taken down after a gain of 3 as they move it from the 22 to the 19. The last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7.
2nd and 7 at the Panthers 19.
Here's Minshew. That's caught by Howard. And they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line.
O.J. Howard.
Not a big window to throw. Coverage wasn't too bad there.
Yeah, they had him under wraps pretty well, but somehow able to muscle his way open and catch the ball.
Gonna give this time to the tailback. And he will have the first down inside the 10 to the 9-yard line. 4 yards on the play, and that leads to the first and goal. A terrific opening drive has them knocking on the door, first and goal. Now a handoff here to his running back. And that play going absolutely nowhere as he's belted before he could get out of the backfield.
This defense is a difficult one to prepare for, one of the best in the league. They'll come at you from all angles, and they did a nice job there stopping him for a loss.
He's going to find his running back. It's complete. And here he'll get it down to the 7. 5 yards that time on the completion, and now it's 3rd and goal.
Brings up 3rd and goal.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the 1 yard line. 6 yards puts him right on the doorstep, and now it'll be 4th and goal.
This is a long drive offensively. Wouldn't you hate to end this with just 3 points?
Doesn't it feel like during a ball game you have certain narratives going on, and there's certain drives that seem to take on just a bit more importance than others? This feels like one of those, doesn't it? To me, 3 points here, a major letdown. This is the time to go and put 6 on the board.
And on their first drive, the offense staying out there. They're going to go for it on 4.
Instead, it goes against them.
On for the field goal. A 23-yard attempt.
And so that kick is good. Well, after marching down the field, only getting 3 there, kind of feels like a win for the defense.
And it does. They'll go to the sideline feeling a lot better that they didn't give up a touchdown after the march against them. But if I were the offense, I wouldn't hang my head over that one. That's a good drive, and 3 points were put on the board.
And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Cost him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20. He's brought down at the 22 after a gain of 2, and it brings up 2nd down.
Brought him down.
Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense that next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one.
Going top shelf for Smith-Schuster. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off right around the 43. And he'll get this one out to the 50 to the midfield strike. What a start defensively. Your offense goes out, gets the touchdown, and then you get the interception. Just perfect.
How about the discipline that they showed on defense? Because after the offense scored to go up 7-0, you would think they might be a little extra aggressive trying to get back at them. Instead, they read their keys well. When they took the shot downfield, they were more than prepared for that one.
48-yard line.
First play of the drive goes the wrong way. Here's 2nd and 12. They'll go play action here with Minshew. Oh, bananas handled the tight end. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. 3 catches now this afternoon, the same number he had all of last week. Also, it's a first down.
At the 36-yard line.
And to give this time to the tailback. Nothing doing. Barely able to muster a yard to hit the 35. Now whistles and a timeout. Looks like we've got a Viking slow to get up. And this will probably be the last play of the quarter. Well, he gets attended to. We'll step aside. Here's 2nd and 9. Minshew sets to throw. The kick here is complete. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Panthers' 24-yard line. 3-0 after 1 on EA Sports. Now a handoff here to his running back. They'll get him to the ground at the 20 following a pickup of 4.
Again, the ball carrier.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team. Defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks, allow other people to make tackles.
And when he can make the play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day. Normally being a big-bodied receiver plays to their advantage downfield, go up and make the catch, take the hit, and pick up yardage. But in this case, the hit was timed really well and popped it free from his grasp.
On third down, Michelle. And they'll get him down about 3 yards short of the first. Just a gain of 2 there, and it's going to bring up a fourth down.
Well, this was just simply excellent defense. On this third down, they had to be alert for the possibility of a pass, but that didn't stop them at all from understanding what was going on when they decided to run the football, and they just swarmed and stopped them for almost no gain.
From inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. And he'll give it here to his running back. And a short pickup there as he'll take this up to right around the 20. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
A gain of 2.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
And he'll go down at the 26, following a gain of 6.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. You'll take that any time you hand the ball to a back.
2 minutes gone by, second quarter. First carry now for the backup, LeSean McCoy. And McCoy is going to be stopped up short. He didn't get him.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
He gets this away. It's a good one. Drawing toward the sidelines. And this punt will go out of bounds. I think it'll be inside the 25. It will. Right at the 24-yard line is where they'll spot it. The Minnesota offense about ready to get this next drive underway. And they had a nice little drive going last time through the interception in the red zone. Costly.
Bad enough to throw it anywhere, but that drives coaches insane when they're thinking about, hey, we've got a shot at points already. We're already in a spot where you're thinking you've got 3 on the board for sure, and to come away with nothing, that's a really tough one for them to swallow.
Yeah, will they make up for it? That first down completion only netted them 3, second and 7. Too strong. They get there and take him down. Jerry Hughes. He's the one to get him, and that is sack number 7 for him on the year.
It's now third down.
The Vikings on third down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This will be third and 15. Rolling to his right. Now he's going to throw deep right side. And knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete. The passing game not in sync here early, and now it's fourth down.
I may be an analyst, but I'm also a fan. I love it when people take the big shots downfield, but he was under a lot of duress, and I think that forced the incompletion downfield. Didn't have a real good chance to find his target.
Good work bringing that one back as he picks up about 16 on the return. And the Panthers will take over now, first and 10. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And you know, there's certainly a lot of football left to play. We're not into December yet, but right now where we stand, they're in first place in their division, looking really good and looking to be a threat come January. And now this is intercepted. My goodness. Picked up around the 41. And the return this time will go out to the 42-yard line. Second interception for him now here in this first half. And you got to think he's a rookie, Charles. How much does confidence start to become a factor?
I think that's a great question because that's what they're going to check on when he gets to the sidelines. The coach is going to check on it. His teammates are going to check on it because when you haven't done it before, it's not something that's part of you. You got to see how you're going to react. Let's see how he bounces back.
Yeah, because 2 interceptions for him in college and a half. I mean, that just didn't happen. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. It's complete. And the Vikings are going to have a first and goal coming up as the tackle made at the 3-yard line. Another good completion on the drive as the Vikings have a first down
at the 3-yard line.
They'll try to run this one in. And they will take this one into the end zone for a Viking touchdown. A great play there. His fourth touchdown on the year. And the Vikings are going to add on to their lead. Touchdown, it's Zuerlein. He'll kick it away. Fielded near the back of the end zone. And he'll just sit on this one as their drive will start at the 25.
At their own 25-yard line.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. They've shown precious little here offensively thus far as they try again with a first down now. Throw right away, and that's complete out on the right side. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. The drive starting with a first down, 11 yards on that pickup. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Now they'll throw here, out of the gun. He's going to get his man out of the backfield, complete. Get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. Rookie quarterback, rookie running back. They team up there to pick up the first. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And he's got it across the midfield stripe and into Viking territory. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and four.
It's a pickup of six. Brings up second and four.
Swindle is running back out of the backfield. Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime.
Panthers.
Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Damon Harrison bringing in 331 pounds of power for the sack. I don't care if you're taking it in round one, you're undrafted, whatever. As a rookie quarterback in this league, you're going to have games where you face adversity like this.
Lessons. All the time you're going to face these lessons. The key for this guy is, will he be able to bounce?
And that'll be intercepted by the Pro Bowl safety, Harrison Smith. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. So his struggle is just continuing here in the first half, throwing the football. Charles, now three interceptions.
And they don't feel like they're just great plays by the defense. There's a sense that maybe he's a little careless with the football now. So some of the great coaches in the past, you know what they've always said? I can't teach you, obviously, because you're not listening. So maybe the bench can teach you. He's got to be careful now. He might get pulled.
And he'll just push his way forward for a few as the clock will run.
It's second.
The last run good for two. Here's second and eight. They'll drop the throw. Has the first down and then some. He finds his tight end Howard. That's complete. Now whistles and a timeout with 3 seconds left in the first half. And unless this is a quick incompletion, this is likely the last play here of this first half. They'll throw now on the final play. The throw here, that's complete. So we have reached halftime with our score 10-0. As we'll head down to Orlando, that's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach!
Greg Zuerlein set to kick off.
The Panthers going to get the football first, trailing here as well as we resume play in the second half. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And in enemy territory last time through the interception. We'll see what they do on this drive.
Can't wait to see how it alters what they decide to do in play calling. Do they continue to throw the ball? Do they want to lean more on the running game? It'll be an interesting sequence of plays that they've got coming up.
Does it often affect the play calling with the interception? How much does that change what you do?
I think it does depending on why the interception was thrown. Sometimes it's just a matter of the defense made a great play, so you continue to come back. But if it's on you, if the offense just doesn't have the confidence, if they're a little bit shaky, maybe try to take the pressure off and run the ball a little bit.
And this one incomplete.
Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
You get the sense that they're saying, we're not playing up to what we're capable of, and we're deep enough into the game that the early jitters are long gone, that they should now have some sense of continuity and be able to make some of these plays that they have not been doing so far.
And a throw there going to be incomplete.
Well, defensively, they haven't let him just sit in the pocket and get comfortable, and that's opposite a lot of game plans in today's NFL. Ordinarily, you're trying to keep the quarterback hemmed in. In this case, they brought the heat, and if he flushes out, they're fine with that, and they force another incompletion.
First and 10 at their own 38-yard line.
Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. They were able to get the ball back here, didn't surrender any points. Now they'll look to add to that lead.
And how about the boost to defense?
Pressure comes in, he's brought down. It's a Panther sack. Bradley Chubb in there to get him, and that is sack number 6 now for him on the year. After the sack, it's second and 19, and the road gets a bit tougher from here. Off play action, it's Minshew. He'll buy some time right. And he finds Howard complete. That catch good for only a yard, and it'll be third down. He was out there waving his arms. Well, you got a quarterback out of the pocket looking for any help. I guess waving the arms is helpful.
It certainly is, because you got to get his attention, because now you're in scramble drill.
That's coming, and down he goes. Josh Allen, he's the one to get him, and that is sack number 7 for him on the year.
Well, partner, we know they came out of the locker room down on the scoreboard. But I will guarantee you, the defensive side of the ball got super emotional. They can come out and play with aggressiveness, with fury, because they don't have to be quite as precise. And it paid off for him on that play, didn't it?
Sure did. Excellent play. Really setting the tone for this third quarter. 35 yards on the return. Picked up some good blocks as well. And possession will switch hands, first and 10.
49-yard line.
Gonna give this time to the tailback. And they go backwards here. Losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. Officially, it's a 1-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
Second and 11.
A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. A gain of 13, it's a first down.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. 11 more yards that go around, a first down as well.
And the Panther first down.
Inside 4 minutes to go, third quarter. Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. Looking for his linebacker, and he's got him. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down.
8 yards on the pickup. Brings up second and 2. At the Vikings 20-yard line.
And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on. Third down. After the incompletion, here now, third and 2.
Yards to go.
With one complete. And he is going to have a Panthers first down, and he's going to have it by plenty. Able to get 8 yards there on third and 2. Rookie to rookie on the hookup there, and it's a first down.
Times these plays, they either go for nothing or they go for big yardage. And here they got to the outside, turned it upfield, and ended up getting a nice little gain out of it.
And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Carolina. A great effort there. His 14th touchdown now on the year. And the Panthers are able to get this back within a touchdown. And they're back within a field goal. It's 10-7 now.
Makes the score Vikings 10, Panthers 7.
And here's Vinatieri now to kick it away after the touchdown. fielded near the back of the end zone. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line.
The Vikings take over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
The Minnesota offense about ready to get this next drive underway. Pretty important third quarter drive for them. Momentum has sort of shifted the other direction after that last touchdown. And a double coverage and it's intercepted. And his guys are going to get the football at the 28-yard line.
They'll take over first and 10 at the 28-yard line.
Now they try the right side here. And he'll be a couple yards shy of the red zone here at the 22-yard line. Call that a gain of 5 as the clock ticks inside of 2 minutes to go now in the third. After the pickup of 5, here's 2nd and 5. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he's going to be stopped just short of the first down marker at the Vikings 15-yard line. 7 yards there, good enough to move the sticks. Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's 1st and 10. Now back to throw. Now they go screen. It's complete. Broken tackle. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And it'll be 2nd and very short.
And inches at the 6-yard line.
Stepping in, and he will take it across for a Panthers touchdown. It's their quarterback scoring on the keeper from 6 yards out. And the Panthers have taken the lead. And maybe the defense caught a little by surprise there that he took off and got in?
Yeah, I would think so, because if you're analyzing it from that side of the ball, you're thinking running back, fullback. Takes you a while before you get to the quarterback.
Adam Vinatieri set to kick off.
And here's Vinatieri now to kick it away after the touchdown. Fielded near the back of the end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23.
The Vikings take over first and 10 at their own 23-yard line.
Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. Now, last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they're going to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens. Third quarter of a tight football game as we come up on a 2nd and 10. He's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. 16 yards, a first down.
And 10 at the 38-yard line.
And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. And he'll give it here to his running back. He'll get about 3 as he's brought down right around the 42. And the trend continues here in the fourth like it was in the first, second, and third. He's had nowhere to run.
And you're probably thinking to yourself, why do they keep feeding him the football? Well, they trust him first and foremost. They do believe that over time he might actually pop one of these runs. But the bottom line is, he takes care of the ball well for them, so they'll keep handing it to him.
So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's 1st and 10. Give him a couple on the carry there. 2nd and 8.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly, and that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
Throwing on 2nd and 8. Minshew out to the left there and completes a hammer. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Panthers 19. That'll wind up a gain of 27 on the catch and run. So here's a 1st and 10 now down inside the 20.
Recon, 1-3-2, fire.
And a give this time to the tailback. And this time they were waiting for him as he'll be knocked out before he can get back to the line of scrimmage.
Ladies and gentlemen, that is a force of nature at the defensive tackle position. Yes, he's as big as they come, but still plenty agile. He's able to make a nice play there to swallow up the ball carrier.
Here's a throw that's taken out of the backfield. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain.
It's a gain of six.
Looked like a pretty good, safe play right there. No, he's had trouble with the interceptions in this game there. Hits his guy out in the flat.
And so many times we hear quarterbacks and offensive coordinators talk about, in your progressions, you're either throwing the touchdown or you're throwing the check down. But earlier in the game, it was touchdown or interception. Now he got to the check down. A nice safe throw and a good one.
And one.
On fourth down, they'll try and run for it. Brought down, but not before he was able to break the tackle, and the extra effort moves the sticks. They only got a couple, but a couple's all that they needed as they convert on fourth.
8 yard line.
They're going to look to throw to the end zone, but it's incomplete.
A lot of times it's that first read that you had. Maybe you get it in pre-snap, and he locked in on his target, but he was covered quite well, and that one's incomplete.
Oh, the pressure there as it's intercepted. It's only Darren Cole, and he returns it up just shy of the 20 to the 19-yard line.
Boy, so another interception, CD. It feels like he's starting to unravel a little bit.
And as you would expect, still a work in progress here in his second season. He has to start ironing out some of these mistakes, though, because now his head coach, his offensive coaches, they have to evaluate whether you keep playing him and let him work through it, or you start thinking about going to his backup.
It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and three. First carry for their fullback. And this is going to be a Panthers first down as he gets this up past the 30. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down.
And a Panther first down.
Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. So it's Panther football as we welcome you back. We're not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. And I think this defense knew what was coming as he is smothered behind the line. They'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
I think it's pretty evident. We can say what a difference a week makes. Last week, he ran pretty much wild, didn't he? Did pretty much what he wanted to do. But this one, they stopped him cold. That, to me, that's good scouting. And even better execution.
Yeah, and they stopped him behind the line right there. They obviously watched the tape a few times and made some adjustments.
They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And he'll slip his way up across the 30 to the 32. After getting stuffed on first down, not much better there. 2 yard gain.
And it's third down.
An important play right here, third and 10.
And I would expect pressure here.
His third down play a little more interesting. Third and 5. Out of the gun. They'll look to throw. Going top shelf. And that's caught inside the 35. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. Touchdown, Carolina. Juju Smith-Schuster. His fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Panthers add on to their lead.
And that touchdown should make you feel comfortable. But do you really feel like it's totally over yet?
Not totally, but I you're pretty much there.
Yeah, you've still got to make sure you stay with it, do all the right things down the stretch, especially on defense. But that touchdown there, you've got to feel good about your chances.
Fielded near the back of the end zone. And the decision to come out of the end zone is going to cost him 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 20.
Kings take over first and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
The Minnesota offense about ready to get this next drive underway. They have a little bit of time left here, but this one not going to go their way.
And this is
too strong. They get there and take him down. The Vikings going to signal for the first of their timeouts. As the clock stops with 23 seconds to go in the game. And they need to work to at least get some of this yardage back after the sack. Second and 19. Another try after the first down sack. Minshew. Oh, there's that man again. It's complete. That catch good for only a yard, and it'll be third down. Short play like that in this situation this late, that's a win for the defense.
No doubt. I remember something Coach Mann used to talk about all the time. Sometimes you can't just take what the defense gives you. You have to take what you need. And in this case, the offense is taking what the defense is giving them, not what they need.
It'll be a gain of 8, but it'll also lead to a fourth down. And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out. And yet again, it's Howard with a catch. And he'll be out of bounds right at the 40. They keep the game alive, at least for the moment, as it's a first down.
First and 10 at the 40-yard line.
So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. Down he goes. And the clock will now stop as a timeout is called with 5 seconds left. And the job becomes twice as difficult now after the sack. It's second and 20. One final shot. They'll look to throw. And this will be incomplete. 1 second left to go.
Incomplete.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. From the gun, Minshew to throw. Incomplete. As time has run out on this football game. So this one is over. A victory for Carolina. And they were buoyed, Charles, by a big second half that put this one on ice.
So you get the sense that whatever was said at halftime obviously hit home. I think it's a little bit more than that, though. Obviously, there are words that are said, and, hey, come on, guys, we have to play better. But sometimes it's just sharpening your execution, sharpening your focus, and maybe doing the things you practiced all week without major adjustments, just doing them better. And that got it done in this one.
So for the Panthers, they continue to be one of the best teams around as they move to 10-2. And they'll be able to enjoy this one through the bye week before they get back at it again. Meanwhile, for the Vikings, they're...
Mind, kamikaze, spaceship power, baby, throw me toward the Yeah.